My name is Camilla Speller, and I'm an archaeologist at the University of York, and I study ancient DNA and ancient proteins from archaeological materials. So one of the most interesting materials that I analyze is dental calculus. If we don't brush our teeth, we can get dental plaque building up on the surface of our tooth. It can slowly harden to become dental tartar or dental calculus. This is so hard that it'll stick to the teeth of archaeological skeletons for thousands of years, and then we can remove it here with a dental pick. Once we're into the lab, we take the dental plaque that we've removed and we dissolve it. And then we look at the proteins that are trapped inside. We analyze it by mass spectrometry. When we get the data back, we compare it against a database of all known proteins. Some of these are the proteins that are formed by the bacteria in our mouth. Some of the proteins are from the food that we eat, and other proteins are from our bloodstream, our own human proteins that can get entrapped into the dental tartar as it's forming in our mouth. One of the most interesting proteins are milk proteins. And as archaeologists, it can be very difficult for us to study milk in the past because it's a liquid. It doesn't tend to preserve in the archaeological record. So other foods that we tend to find are cereals. So we can find plants like wheat proteins, for example, in the mouth. But we also find a lot of bacterial proteins. A lot of these are harmless, but others of them can cause disease. So in the past, we can see that people suffered from some of the same dental problems that we have today, and we can see some of the same bacteria causing gingivitis or inflamed gums in the past as we do in the present. One of the most interesting findings we had was from a Neolithic skeleton, and we found in their mouth evidence of wheat and milk. So these are some of the earliest farmers in Britain. We weren't very sure how much milk they might have been consuming. And by finding milk proteins inside the dental plaque of these individuals, we know that they're definitely using dairy products. So this new method of analysis by looking at dietary proteins inside the mouth is allowing us to explore basically when and where and how people started to first exploit the milk of their domestic animals. I think there's also a lot that we can learn about people's ancient diets, not just about their milk consumption, but also about a whole range of different foods that they might have eaten in the past. For example, plant foods can be very difficult to track in the archaeological record because they tend to break down. And so if we find plant proteins entrapped in the dental calculus, that gives us a better indication of what kind of foods people might have been eating. We have the chance of understanding more about the diseases that people suffered from, like colds and flus, and trying to find evidence of bacteria and viruses associated with those diseases. So in the end, hopefully what we'll receive is a much more comprehensive picture of what people's lives were like in the past.